not stuck, right? But you got two to three different phases, all right, that kind of look at it, right? You got the novice, people come in, when they first come into the war, they're from novice. From intermediate, they go from novice to intermediate, and then intermediate to advanced, okay? So let's go with this, right? So people come in, you know, they become novice, then they got to go over to their technique, right? Their technique is big. They're learning everything, they're usually pretty bad at it, bad at everything. So if we start, right, the right way, we want to go to technique. Okay, then the thing that everyone's got to start understanding is the linear progression that it takes. That's why I'm trying to get you to log everything. So especially as a novice, because you guys will keep going up from week to week, for weeks. I mean, it could be 12 weeks before you plateau. That's what, how incredible it can be, you know? But you have to know, like I talked about, where you're at on these particular lifts. And you have to know your style. You got to know where you're at on the pull-up. Like, what's your style? Is it with the band? You know, is your style with, you know, just is doing the supine? Like, I feel like you should know. After the first couple of weeks, you should know your style and the progression of it, right? From the bands to the pull-up. Okay, so tracking results. Okay, so then you start getting a little better at the movements. And then what happens? Maybe you're able to increase your intensity. So then I come to you and I say, look, you're getting pretty good at these movements. You've got to increase your intensity. And you got to go harder. You got to challenge yourself more on the weight, on the loading. Try to go a little heavier. Okay? And then that's how you progress, right? And then the same thing goes with nutrition. Maybe develop a little bit of an understanding of nutrition where you're at. Maybe you're trying it. Maybe you've added almonds into your nutrition and a little bit of water. Make this little bit of progress, right? So then they make this person follows this, their technique comes along, and they move into the intermediate. Okay? So I kind of talked about last night about stimulating our central nervous system. Okay? So how we do that in weightlifting is when it's 90% and above of your one rep max. So this the novice, they can't stimulate their central nervous system because you guys can't take your intensity high enough to stimulate. You know what I'm saying? When your body starts, if you want your body to start changing, you want to see some results, you want to get stronger, you got to get to this point where you can stimulate your central nervous system. You got to know where your one rep max is. You got to be able to take it above 90% on the split jerk and on the squat. You see what I'm saying? And then that's how it'll start coming. Then you'll start gaining an understanding of like the percentages. So like when I come to you guys and say, okay, 70% of the one rep max on the low bar back squat. Like that's, you know what that is. On pulling out your phone, you know what your one rep max is in the back squat. You know, it's like maybe it's 385 times 9.70. Bam, you know what to do in this workout today. Maybe you look at that online so you know exactly what you're going to do. Okay? So then it comes with that setting personal records. So when we find our one rep max, you guys are like, all right, my one rep max is 385. I want to get 390. You know that. It's exciting. So you're looking forward to it all day long. You want to get that. Then you set that PR, and it is up high. You will be, it feels good to be like, holy, you know. You're going and telling everybody, I'm clean and jerk. You know, I put 275 on my head, you know. If I can get a person from a novice to an intermediate, I can show you a way to get away from your addiction. You know what I'm saying? That's the way I'm looking at it in the gym experience. Because by then I will have shown you that like that this is fun. And I don't want to put anything bad in my mind.
Is it easier to get away
from
the addiction versus the novice?
I think so.
Yeah.
Right, but the advanced will come if that means you're into it, right? I'm going to get into it. It's not good. So then, so let's say PR. So then you start progressing in the clear movements. So who knows what the clear movements are? I haven't touched base with you on those. Those are like the body weights. So the handstand push-ups, right? That's one that takes a long time, especially for females and males too. The ring dips, you know? Getting stronger those where you can do them without a band. Pull-ups, being able to string 15 to 20 of them together. You know, progressing on those movements, okay? and the barber, right? And then next thing you know, you're like, I want to get some shoes, you know, or you want to get some gear. I love it when I see somebody get some gear because I'm like, hey, they're getting into this. I still see a lot of people not getting gear, and I'm just like, how? I mean, would you play soccer without cleats? No, you wouldn't. So we should get into the shoes, you know, or gear, or, you know, maybe some wrist wraps or whatever. I like the supplements for people who have got the recovery, you know, that, I mean, it tells me you're getting serious, you're wanting to feel better, right? And then, now you're understanding nutrition, maybe you're living the nutrition 75 to 85 to 90%, and you really are getting understanding of the art of nutrition. If I've got you there, that's sick, like, then I'm gonna transition you into advanced, and like, you're gonna do well with your addiction, you're not gonna wanna do it. So then, now it's become like a sport where you're trying to get better for sure. You know, now maybe you're thinking about, I want to see what my time is. I want to compete with these guys. I want to beat everyone in this gym. You know, I want to be stronger. I want to be well-rounded. The clear movements, the strong movements, the balance. I want to be well-rounded. That's the secret to this. Now you're doing muscle-ups. You know, you're out here, when I have a workout on the board prescribed for muscle-ups, you're doing it. And it's fun. That you understand linear progression, you're trying to understand weightlifting, you're trying to understand the programming, like when to back off, when to listen to your body. If your posterior chain is just wrecked, I need to maybe take a day off, you know? You understand everything. You know exactly where you're at when you lift. If I see you in Costco, and I say, hey, where's your clean and jerk at? You grab it to me really quick. Your snatch, you know exactly where it's at. Your deadlift. Right? How many muscle-ups have you been stringing together in a row? You know, how many pull-ups have you done in a row? Like, you know all these things, and that's cool, right? Your intensity is always high. You've gotten comfortable being uncomfortable. So now it's like, you like that feeling when you're in a workout and it hurts and you're sucking wind, and so you're just like, but you're cool with it. You're like, this is sick. I'm in an escape right now, right? Supplements, you're doing the progenics, you know, maybe you're on creatine, you know, I like the creatine, I don't like to get, I'm not promoting like stimulant supplements or any of that shit, but I like the supplements that are good for our bodies, the recovery, the protein shake, because that means you're tying it into nutrition, you know, some fish oil so you're recovering better, you know. Now you're even more into gear, you got your own personal bag, maybe with your name on it, you know, and you got in here, it's a big ass bag. Tape, chalk all over you a lot of the time. You know, it's just everything. Shoes, tape, you know, you tape your fingers because they're going to rip because you're going to go that hard, you know. In the wintertime, you grow a beard, you know, like, you know, if you're into it, you're into the style, then you get attacked. You know, your sleep and your nutrition is 90% to 100%, give or take, you know, and you're working that nutrition. You know, lifting weights 4 days a week, and then you're involved on the weekend and the one experience. Like, and that is sick. You know what I'm saying? Like, that would be a good way of life. I've seen, you know, I don't know, I haven't really seen anybody. My brother-in-law, he was supposed to come. My buddy Boyer out here, they're more the advanced. You know, I live in the advanced way. I try to get stronger constantly. My nutrition is what holds me back a little bit in the sleep. But, like, And then you tie it with the rest of the lifestyle that I'm promoting, with the spiritual, the reading, the writing. Like, that's a sick ass way to live life, you know? But it's hard. I mean, I don't think very many people live this way of life, this lifestyle in the world. But isn't that cool? I think that's badass to be just living that way and being healthy like that, carrying yourself around in that kind of life. I don't know. So that's really what I'm trying to get people to do, you know, and it's hard to do it as me as a coach, you know. But if you really wanted to do this, like, getting that, you can do it. It just takes you asking questions and doing stuff outside of the gym, YouTube, Google, you know, the CrossFit Journal. I think everyone in here should have a membership to that. It's $25 a year. And it's, you get a little login, and like, it's sick, they give you so much information.
What is it?
It's called the CrossFit Journal. It's just on CrossFit.com. $25 a year. Videos of everything, nutrition inside, interviews, you know, just tie it and get you, it just, it's a good resource for sure. My wife's really into the CrossFit, and I look at it a lot too. But it's just that way, if I can get, I mean, if I could take a kid or a guy, a 20-year-old, whatever you want, a kid, 25, whoever comes into this, and they're struggling with their addiction, if I can get them to clean and jerk 275, put that over there, thoughts could pop into their mind about maybe using opiate or whatever it is, but the lifestyle will outweigh it and you'll be able to do it. And it's really good. I live it myself. I know this lifestyle will keep me right, stay away from the pills. And even if I do relax, I'm strong enough to make it happen back. Because of this lifestyle, it's a good foundation. So, I don't know if anybody got anything.
Hard to come in from over. Hard to come in to the gym from over.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So if you're doing it 4 days a week, it's a lot easier to stay sober.
Yeah.
And if you're doing it 4 days a week, it'd be hard.
Oh,
it'd be hard to do anything. I find the guy who comes in. Find life in this thing, way of life, and they'll be like, and then they get lazy, you know, and then they'll live in it. Dude, the disease of addiction doesn't go away. Like, it flares up just like cancer flares up. You know, if a cancer patient quits taking their medication and quits doing chemo, what happens? If cancer and disease flares up. If we stop putting more medication into our system, my disease is going to flare up. Jason's coming Thursday, so that'll be good. He's going to ask her all kinds of questions. He's going to talk about snacks, like what kind of snacks to make, but paleo-friendly snacks.
She's talking about snacks.
That's what she's doing.
Oh,
is she? Nice, dude. Good stuff. That was fun.